Welcome to another video of the Millennial Guru. This is Utkarsh and I am going to tell you today about marketing and presentation skills. There are many corporations, companies, organizations which are selling products, different kind of services, and we are buying them. The production cost, the manufacturing cost of these products is minimal, but when we are paying for it, when we are buying the products from the market, we are paying 10 folds of the original cost. The reason behind it is we are not buying the product itself, we are not buying the thing, we are buying the idea behind the product. We are buying the emotion that is stirred inside us when we buy this product. So there are companies that sell a product, but they also sell the idea behind it and image behind it. The best observations you can make are the American organizations. Let's talk about Coca-Cola is an American brand of soft drink. And Coca-Cola is it's marketed to us with a definition of fun. Every party, every good time, every celebration is incomplete without Coca-Cola. That's the idea that we have. Whenever we want to celebrate, we buy Coke. Not cocaine, obviously, but Coca-Cola. The reason for this is because our mind tells us that every celebration function is incomplete without the Coke. The same goes for pizza. Pizza is actually an Italian food, which is marketed by American food industry. And pizza is the definition of having fun. Pizza is the definition of party. Every celebration is incomplete without a pizza. So every millennial today is out there, and what do you want to have? Well, I would love to eat a pizza. No doubt there are so many great other food items in the world, but when it's a question of a celebration or a birthday party, people will choose a pizza. Not just because they love it, but because of the emotion that is stirred behind the word pizza. These organizations are very smart in selling products. They use fancy sounding words. They use exotic words and vocabulary. And the moment we listen to these words, we are tempted to buy it, because these words are actually stirring up emotions inside us. You go to a restaurant with Indian food. Now, Indian food is also, it is packaged in a way that sounds exotic to us. So we want to eat the same chapati and sabji, but then we want to hear those good fancy words. The way the food they're preparing is described to you, a puree of tomatoes and sliced cottage cheese and sauteed in olive oil, a dash of corianders and a hint of basil and garlic and a little bit of parsley sprinkled on the top. Indian bread dough kneaded with milk and corianders, and that becomes a roti, that's a naan basically. And that's what you're eating. You're basically eating paneer tikka masala with roti. The cauliflower is an Indian product that is eaten in every household. Cauliflower, the cost of cauliflower, I guess, is hardly 20 to 30 rupees kg. But then there's a similar product, a similar vegetable, it's broccoli. And broccoli is not just a vegetable, it's an idea, it's an emotion. And the broccoli's cost is at least 3 to 4 times, or maybe even 5 times more than cauliflower. Because broccoli sounds amazing. Broccoli, baby corn, sun-dried tomatoes, parsley. Look at these words. We humans love fancy words. We love fancy sounding words. Especially us Indian people, we're crazy when it comes to English words. This goes very well for pizza. Sun-dried tomatoes, mixed herbs, garlic, oregano, jalapenos, tomatoes, onions. So the way it is described, we are tempted to buy it. The same goes for bakery. You might find bakeries in Valsad, you might find bakeries in a small town. Oh, but you go to Bandra. There, it's a patisserie, not a bakery, it's a patisserie. Look at the cakes, they're just cakes and pastries. But look at the words that come with it. Sinful chocolate cake, devil's mousse cake, where's the devil? Death by chocolate. Look at these words. All these words are coming with an idea. So all these words, they stir up emotions inside us. When Apple sells you a phone, they're not selling you a phone, they're selling you the image that comes with the iPhone. When you buy an iPhone, you're not buying an iPhone because it's not just a phone, it's an iPhone. The idea behind iPhone is the name itself. We are not buying iPhone for its features, just for the camera. Obviously, we love the camera, definitely. But we also buy it for the headphones. So they're normally all our headphones, right? Earphones, headphones. But no, iPhone doesn't sell headphones. They sell you AirPods. Oh my God. AirPods. That's like amazing. AirPods, as in the moment you put them in your ear, you're going to start flying. It's going to give you wings. So that's what basically they're selling you. They're selling you the word itself, AirPod. Normal headphones, 2K, 3K, 4K. AirPods, 12K. That's the secret behind selling. Red Bull gives you wings. So that's the whole idea. It's a soft drink that gives you an idea. In the early 19th century, people invented smoking tobacco. And gradually over the years, they polished the product and they finally made something called a cigarette. And when the cigarettes came out, cigarettes were a new product. People did not know what cigarettes did. What was the purpose of cigarettes? So, the American industry started selling it as a product that was good for you, that was healthy for you. They started selling it in the early 20th century, that is the 1920s. A lot of advertisements began. Companies like Lucky Strike, Marlboro Man, these companies were advertising their products as if the products were useful and healthy for people. Hollywood, the film industry of America, glamorized it. They made it cool, and on-screen smoking was the symbol of sophistication. People smoked because it looked cool on screen. And over the years, smoking has sunk into our culture. And every fifth person you know might be smoking. There are so many smokers around us. There are so many people who are smoking in the whole world today. And even in spite of knowing how harmful it is and how it's not doing you any good, we are programmed to think that we are addicted to it. We need it and we can't function without cigarettes. You might not be smoking, but a lot of people do. And the interesting thing about this, the irony about the cigarette, is that this product is a product which is not at all useful. It doesn't help you in any way. It is not even good for your health. It has zero function in your life. A person can spend his entire life without smoking, and he doesn't need to smoke. As in, this product itself is useless, it's invalid, and you don't need it. And still, you will see a cigarette shop at the corner of every street. You will find it more than medical shops, chemist shops, and any useful item for that matter. You won't find a shop, but you will find a cigarette shop in every part of the town, in every nook and corner of the country. So it's very interesting to understand how this marketing works, how we are all programmed to buy things. When you're buying electronics, there's something called extended warranty. Basically, it's the same. No matter what warranty you're buying, whether you're buying a warranty or not, if your product stops working, you are paying money from your own pocket. But you are going to pay extra amount of money for the extended warranty. So extended warranty is again a scam. When you go to a bank, they have normal banking and then they have privileged banking. Whoa. Privileged banking, amazing, that sounds so good. So again, I don't want regular banking, now I want the privileged banking. So that's the case with everything that we do. So when you are selling yourself, when you are presenting yourself to the people, use the right word, because it's your words that is going to create an impact. It is those words that's going to decide your MRP. Everybody has an MRP. People are earning low wages, next to nothing. And then there are people making billions in salary because of the word they use to describe themselves. If you're not a barber, you should be a hair stylist. You're not going to a barber shop. You're not going to a hair cutting shop. It's a hair salon. Wow. I would want to go to a hair salon. I wouldn't want to go to a barber shop. You are not train driver. You are a locomotive pilot. When organizations are giving a small amount of salary to their employees, basically they're just giving them peanuts. But then they don't call it salary. They'll calculate the entire salary of the year and they'll tell you, oh, we are offering you a package of 2 lakh. That's per year. That's nothing, basically. So you feel proud in telling, oh, I have a package. Basically, it's a salary. Everyone gets a salary. But what you're saying, it's a package. So all these words that we use in daily life, they actually program our mind and a response towards them. If the right word is used, you will go for it. You will be tempted to buy it. So similarly, when you are presenting yourself, when you are selling yourself, when you are in the market communicating with your clients, your customers or people you deal with, make sure you use the right kind of language, the right kind of vocabulary, because people pay for the words, the emotions and the idea behind the product, not just for the product. So when you're presenting yourself, when you're writing a sentence in your resume, make sure it sounds good, it sounds effective, and you're presenting it in the same way these corporations do. So instead of saying, well, I changed a light bulb, here's what you're saying. Single-handedly managed the upgrade and deployment of new environmental illumination system with zero cost overruns and zero safety incidents. Wow, that's what Shashi Tharoor does. That's what we are doing. You are selling vada pav and you are rebranding it, renaming it as burger. And that 10 rupees vada pav is sold as a 100 rupee burger. So when you are describing your post, whatever you are doing, whatever post you are, whatever work you do, it is the presentation that's important. It's the words that you use that will sell your work. It is those words, those same words, the right kind of words will create the impact that you are aiming for. The wrong words will just leave you struggling. There are so many videos that we watch on daily basis, but ultimately we don't implement them. The most necessary part of watching these self-help videos is applying them in your life. Application is the key. If you don't apply these ideas, they are a waste. They are just going to go away. So apply them in your life. Implement the ideas that you watch in a video. Rather than watching 10 videos and not apply a single thing, just watch one video but use it in your life. I hope this video helps you in improving your presentation skills, your salesmanship and your marketing skills. Thank you for watching this video. This is Utkarsh, your millennial guru. I'll see you next week. Please don't forget to subscribe this channel, share it with your friends and like the videos. Thank you for watching this video.